Over the years at FCP Euro, our builds focused on track car nostalgia. Now we're flipping the script and changing from tarmac to rallying. The goal is overcrest rally in a chassis that rarely sees dirt. Nate Vincent was the mastermind behind Golden Era, and Alex Nelson engineered the 850. For this project, they've teamed up to redesign this stock Cayman into a gravel-slinging machine. Welcome to Rallye Cayman. After purchasing our bone stock Cayman, we shook it down in the snow at Team O'Neill. Nate got his first feel of proper snow driving, but now we're back at the shop to strip her down and start the process of a real rally car.
You thrashed it in New Hampshire. You know what it can do as a stock 987S. Let's make it a little bit better by taking it apart. What are we gonna start with today?
You gotta basically take the entire car apart, strip the interior, strip everything fabric out of the car, pull some of the harness back, doors, hatches, everything.
A lot of people like to modify and retrofit these seats into 996s per se. So with that, Nate, thank you so much for the seats. We're gonna be installing these. Stay tuned if you wanna see how to install 997, 987 seats and a 996 chassis. All right, Nate, let's do it.
Once the seats were out, we started the stripping process. Door cards, engine cover, steering wheel, carpets, all needed to go.
Left 45, straight, straight, 3, 6, 10, 7 degrees, 6, H5, lift, jump, jump.
But with only a few more things to strip out of the Cayman, we loaded it up for the first big step in rally car transformation, the roll cage. We're headed a few hours north to Massachusetts to see Bill Doyle, a longtime rally cage builder.
So when you go to Massachusetts, it's like rite of passage to, it's like the checkpoint at the border is a Dunkin' Donuts.
You have to go through there. That's fair.
Get a couple donuts and they're like, all right, you can go. Keep going.
Yes.
It's beautiful.
Always the trailer fight.
Oh, it's terrible.
The main hoop has to have an X. Mm-hmm. That's rally required. You need a sill bar, and then you need the X, and then you need the A-pillar support bars, and then everything gets gusseted.
But really, I mean, the rally bars just have a couple of bars, like, basically to keep, like, you roll over, rocks can't puncture through here, you slide sideways into something, there's an extra bar to keep that
from
caving in on you.
Yeah, okay. And that'll also qualify you to run this at Mount Washington.
Yep.
Or Pikes Peak.
We'll see.
Yeah.
I just got a little excited there for a second.
You've done a cluster?
And then you get rid of the...
Bill's talents are particularly homegrown, with his measuring and welding done in a carport and the pipe bending performed in his home basement. It's not always what you have, but how you use it. And in no time, Bill had bent the main hoop to perfect fitment.
Main hoop to a Cayman.
That's awesome. That is impressive.
So that's what you work off of. That's cage a Cayman.
Yeah, we're gonna cage a Cayman.
We left Bill to his devices, and in a few weeks, he had most of the cage tacked into place. It was time for us to come back and test Nate's fitment in the car. Having the driver's head as far away from the roof as possible is extremely important in a rally car, because rally crashes can be excessively violent. The more headroom, the safer you are from any roof impact. And this is hard in a Cayman, because the car's cabin is pretty small.
Oh, dude, you're a mile away from it.
Yeah, I mean, I can like, I can fully pick a wedgie while driving with a helmet on, so we're good.
Yeah.
We're good. It happens, I mean, you gotta be comfortable. It's gonna be hot in here, you know how it's gonna be.
Windshield view.
There's absolutely no issue with vision over here, and I'm only losing just a teeny bit directly in the pillar. Like, if I were driving, I'd probably be more like this. which gives me even more room, I think. Do you want my helmet?
Yeah, sure. It's an honor.
I have a pretty big head. That's not gonna work. At this point, has the Volvo episode been out yet?
It better be.
Well, I'm Alex. I'm the, I guess, integration engineer at this point, who will be helping Nate turn this into a rally car. And yeah, let's see if I fit. Oh, I fit fine. Here, let's bring it forward.
Yeah, you're good.
And if I scooch forward and we took the cushion out, I could fit with a helmet.
Yeah, so the back of the bracket's touching the trans tunnel. The front of the bracket, you have about a half an inch.
Okay. There you go, you went up a little more.
That's
okay.
All right, well, I'm gonna be the co-driver. This is what it feels like when the Air Force finds out you wear glasses and you can't join and fly the cool planes. That's what this feels like.
Not one of us.
Yeah, exactly. I get to read the book and get and throw up.
Yeah.
It's gonna be great.
Long ain't wrong.
Yeah, so are you planning to...
That's true. I moved this back a little more than
normal,
which is why this is long, but that's okay. Like I said, long ain't wrong. Yeah, I have two rules in my shop, right? First, long ain't wrong. Second, it can't fall off the floor. If you're worried about it falling, just put it on the floor.
Bill, we've only known each other for about an hour, but you're great. I'm really glad we met.
All right, so everything looks really good in here. Next time, we'll be coming here to pick the car up.
Yeah.
What do you think that's going to be?
Maybe a week, week and a half.
Bill has done an absolutely awesome job. Let's get this thing out of here.
For what seemed like no time at all, our Cayman went from a stock Sunday driver to a caged rally chassis. Now it was time for Alex to work his magic. Using a scan tool and spray, the entire chassis is captured and transformed into a SolidWorks model. This scan data allows for precise design and fitment of new rally bits. Focusing on the interior of the car first, Alex models a new seat position, as well as shifter and handbrake brackets.
What we're going to be doing is 3D scanning the seats, and then 3D scanning the seats on top of some packing blankets and stuff with us in them. In the car to try to get an idea of where the best driver position is. And then from there, I'll make brackets that go directly up to those positions, so it's a perfect fit. The real highlight of all of what we're about to do is that I'm about to try to get into this.
No problem. You got it.
I'm in. Perfect.
So basically, you need to go as far back as possible.
I need to just go as far back as possible. We have room to put the hardware in. No, we don't. Hold on. Go back. I mean, I think that's about as good as it's going to get for me. So the only issue is that I didn't teach you how to scan, and now I'm in here.
So what do I need to do?
So if you just want to take that scanning spray and run up the side of the seat real quick, go to that little resolution box in the lower left.
This is 1.0.
Yep, that's fine. And then hit start. And then just hold the scanner about 14 inches away from the dots. And I'm gonna try not to move. And I think, so that gauge on the left is how close or far away you are. You're too close right now. Back up a little bit.
Okay, I wanna be in the middle of my green.
Yep. Yeah, that looks great. I think we're good to try putting you in the seat.
I'm better at getting in the seat, but I'm not as good at scanning the seat. I would say right about, yeah, that's full clutch.
All right, so you have a harder job than I did because you can't just rest against the car.
So,
here, also close your eye. Here, close your eye. All right, now you have to stay still. It's like when you're in class and you don't want to laugh, but your friends are laughing, so it gets worse.
Mm-hmm.
All right, we're good.
You guys want me to hop in there, sir, see where I'm at or what?
You're where I'm at. Except you usually sit like this.
Dude, you gotta be close.
I like being close, but like comfortably close. Alex, you like this?
Yeah, that's perfect.
We can keep the hydraulic stuff separate. Obviously, the pedal stuff will be coming through here, so we'll have brake lines for that rear will come through here, go through the master cylinder, and then go back.
Yep. Yeah, so what I'm gonna do, that was, you can tell I've spoken English my whole life because that was all one word. What I'm gonna do, we're gonna scan both these things as they are because they're in the exact location we want them to be. I'll scan it as it is, and then we're gonna remove them, and I'll scan the handbrake and the shifter separately, get all the bolt patterns for both, and then I already have a scan of the transtunnel, so then I can build a mount once I align this scan, and this scan all together. I can build a mount that just goes between the car and the shifter, and the car and the handbrake. Okay, so now that we have the scans of everything in the car aligned, Nate's seating position, my seating position, the seat itself, the shifter, handbrake, now that we have all that in CAD, I was able to just make sheet metal parts that just connect everything together. Firstly, we have these pieces of aluminum here, which have a tunnel through the middle, so that way we can pass lines and whatever we need to. That raises the factory shifter up to where Nate had it in the car, and it bolts down to these OEM mounts. Then there's a 1/4-inch thick piece of A36 steel that bolts on top of all of that, and that suspends the handbrake and puts the cylinder, the master cylinder, just above where the seat side comes down. So it should just fit, and hopefully in a few weeks after Oshkut gets this fiber laser cut and bent for us in Orem, Utah, we'll have these pieces ready to drop into the car, and it should fit perfectly first time because scan data rocks. So we'll give it a shot. We actually built these to the FIA specification, which is for steels. There has to be at least 3 millimeters of just steel in between each mounting point or in between each reinforcement. For aluminum and other alloys, it has to be 5 millimeters distance. They don't really give a whole lot of other regulation aside that. So in between each one of these holes, there's at least 3 millimeters, and I made sure that that was consistent throughout. We're probably gonna have to weld these little bend reliefs here just so that that way it doesn't start to crack. But otherwise, this should be ready to go right into the car.
So as you can see, we have no rails. We can really basically bolt this directly down to the original seat mounts, and that allows us to get the butt of the actual composite seat as low as physically possible in here. The art of installing a race car seat into a pre-caged car. Just to show the optimization that Alex was able to, I cannot slide my finger under there. The front lip of the seat is literally on the car right now. So, you know, we literally put the seat as low as we could get it.
As low as it could physically be.
And then to that point, you know, Bill, when he built the cage, optimized that as much. If you really want to see there, you can see this brace right here was actually cut out and the roll bar was pushed to the edges of the car, like actually beyond the edges of the car, I should say, to make sure there's enough room. So there's definitely a lot of our effort here is like,
yeah,
making room for things.
Yeah, the seat fitment to the cage is equally tight.
Yeah, I mean, if you look right here.
Yeah, or the top. And while Nate is getting the bolts tight on that side, I'm gonna show you guys how the shifter mount works. Shout out to Porsche for making the factory studs very, very long. So then there's a spacer plate, this guy. This slides in right here. So this is the handbrake mount. It then slides in right over top, like so.
What's the DR stand for?
Driver's side. This is the passenger side, I mislabeled it.
Engineer.
He's been caught.
As you can see, it's literally right up against the seat.
Speaking of clearances again.
And then this guy, there's a little indexing nub right here. This just drops in. You wanna slide yourself in there?
Yeah, let me grab the steering wheel. Let's feel this thing out.
I really can't complain at all.
Yep. Listen to that. Listen to how bad this shifter sounds.
It's like my screen door.
It's so bad.
So steering wheel obviously will be a little bit smaller and we will space it out a little bit back here. So there'll be a little bit more of a gap here.
And we're gonna need a quick release for me to get in.
Yeah, we will need a quick release because that makes the life a lot easier.
Yep.
Yeah, definitely. He's just going nuts over here. He's like,
it's good.
Kidding a Chuck E. Cheese.
It's good. There's enough room.
I'm 6 foot six and I'm built like a frog. Actually, this is a German car. I'm built like a Frosch. The fact that I fit in this is amazing. We're definitely gonna need a 330 millimeter wheel. So yeah, the swing of my elbow is perfect. But yeah, let's test fit the center console and just see what it looks like.
Compared to where we were, so just...
Perfect.
Oh, dude,
you can't really get much closer than that. Oh. All you have to do is pull the handbrake and die in order to adjust your temperature. No big deal.
You ready? Go. Our friends over at Mako, Kevin, is going to be painting the interior in this car, the front, the trunk, basically all the inside bits that we've been grinding on, welding on, the cage, all of that. But we're going to be obviously doing it the body color of this Cayman. Honestly, whenever you do fabrication like this, you get all the welds and the grinds, and it kind of starts to look a little ugly. We're off to Fishkill, New York. Mako.
Nate is bringing back the Cayman from Fishkill, New York. The interior should match the exterior now, and even parts that Porsche didn't paint are painted now. So I'm really excited to see it. We have Nate and mini Nate.
Say hi, Oliver.
Hi.
Holy smokes.
I mean, the cage is super spectacular.
Let's roll down the sun so everyone can see it. Yeah. That's awesome.
With the paint done, all the fab work is now sealed and protected. Plus, the color came out great. Not many race cars have factory paint matched interiors. Mako did a great job. But we're just getting started. The cage is in and looking more rally ready. But next time, we're pulling the engine. It's time to tackle the heart of this Cayman, prep it for competition, and ensure its reliability off-road.